To clear up a little misunderstanding with the authorities, basically the law, on what my intentions were with Rikishi this past Sunday at No Mercy.
I can't believe it.
You see what happened after a spirited contest.
What?
After a hell of a competition, I offered Rikishi a ride to the parking lot in my truck.
What is he talking about? Offered a ride?
After I got Rikishi out of the truck and he seems to have fallen and couldn't get up.
I can't believe.
Realizing I had done all I could do for the man, the cops thought that when I backed up and that truck shot forward, they thought that maybe I was trying to run over Rikishi like some big fat speed bump. No!
Is this the Stone Cold we know, King?
That's not what happened. I wouldn't do that. I explained to the authorities, the Stone Cold Steve Austin is not the kind of man that would bear a grudge like that against another human being.
What?
I explained to the authorities that when I broadsided that police cruiser, I'd accidentally stepped on the gas instead of the brakes, and it was completely 100% accident.
It wasn't an accident. He was trying to run down Rikishi.
And when that truck jumped out of gear and went backwards, shot back into gear, went forwards, and I crashed in that police cruiser again, through it all, Stone Cold Steve Austin refused to press charges on the police officer driving that vehicle.
He refused to press charges on the police. Has he been drinking?
I don't know. That's a good question.
What the?
Anyway, they decided today would give me a ride to the police department and brought in on the cases of defamation of property. And I said, what's defamation of property? And they said, basically, Steve, we're getting you for littering.
Littering?
It seems that, you know, when you go down the road and you throw like a hamburger sack out the window, they give you like a $300 fine. When I dumped 425 pounds of crap right there in the middle of Albany, New York, you can imagine the fine levied on Stone Cold Steve Austin.
He's talking about Rikishi when he dumped
him
out of the pickup truck.
You mean all he got charged with was littering?
Anyway, we cleared that all up. I made it to Raw, and I would like to thank Commissioner Mick Foley for his understanding and his help. Thank you, Mick. I sure appreciate it.
Thank you, Mick Foley.
In doing so, I promise Mick that I would not lay one single hand on Rikishi unless I was absolutely, positively provoked.
Uh-oh, provoked? I don't get this, really, I don't.
I don't either, King. I agree with you there.
I'm gonna live up to this. As long as Commissioner Mick Foley lives up to his word that I got Rikishi's fan in a steel cage this Monday night on Raw.
What?
Pressure to Foley says Austin's going to have Rikishi in a steel cage on Raw?
But I'm going to tell you right here, right now, if Rikishi provokes me, Stone Cold Steve Austin, here in Long Island.
Yeah, he's taking after Foley.
Well, let me put it this way. If he provokes me tonight in Long Island, if you think I should just go ahead and whip the hell out of him, open up a can of whoop ass, give me a hell yeah.
It's unanimous.
And that's exactly what's going to happen. And that's the bottom line, because Stone Cold said so.
An unusual interview, King. A strange interview from Stone Cold Steve Austin, who's apparently given Commissioner Mick Foley his word. He's not going to touch Rikishi unless promoted, because he gets Rikishi in a cage on Raw Monday night.
So you want to get provoked, huh? Right.
Hey, what the hell does Rikishi mean by that?
I don't know, but I don't believe Austin. He's evil!